His name was Robert Paulson. Wait, wrong story. His name was Freddy Wood. Son of Arthur and Molly. Nephew of Otis Pike. While his father was busy running Grafton Steel, his mother was supposed to be taking care of Freddy. Arthur, preoccupied with work, was unaware Molly ordered a customized Miss Nanny to care for Freddy. What could she possibly be engaged in? Her use in Allegheny were supposed to have helped her. Would Miss Annie have answers after all these years? Not without his kid secure ID. She only wanted to task him with finding himself. While Freddy was finding his past, the overseer had been busy fabricating more Halo tit movies. Explaining pre- and post-war state of affairs. Freddy had missed so much. The overseer could not take her eyes off of him. Lovelust consumed her. Davenport had constructed a special research project on possible Molly locations before the war. With the locations loaded into his pit boy, Freddy needed to see for himself. How could this be? Molly died before the war. Otis and Arthur were working together to protect Freddy from his mother. He traveled to Davenport's last known location of Molly. It was all true. And explicit. I set it up. That's me in the corner. That's she was in fact like losing my religion, trying to keep up you. The most distinguished pre-war guest of Appalachia. Molly lived a double life. Every waking hour, I'm choosing my confessions. She would leave Freddy with Miss Annie while disappearing for days. Like a hurt, lost and blind without Arthur's knowledge or consent. When Otis found out Freddy was abandoned, he devised a plan with Arthur to not only help create a super insignificant side quest, but to buy Arthur time to follow her. Molly had many victims, mostly married men with children. Namely one Todd Sanders Sr. His body was barely identifiable by authorities. Molly was a secret member of Haven Church. She bore fruit from her indiscretion with another member, a camp counselor, who was also committed to Allegheny before the war. That's me in the spotlight, losing my religion, trying to keep up you, and I don't know if I can do it. Oh no, I've said too much, I haven't said. Arthur and Otis had no idea of how buried Molly's dark and deep skeletons were. Freddy had come full circle. His true father took by fear and cowardice. His mother took by force and deception. Freddy was the offspring of the Mephistophelian. How did Freddy survive this set of circumstances? Was he the luckiest and unluckiest dweller in the wasteland? One person might have direction for him. Leo had been experimenting with different business strategies. The Nuka World on Tour tours for 40,000 caps was a complete flop. Like many people, he had overpriced everything. 2,000 caps for a chainsaw flamer mod. 150 caps for soot flower tea recipes. 40 caps for a Stimpak.
No, seriously, lower your prices, people. Do you wonder why you are always broke? Bathrobes are not rare. Get them from the Asultrin vendor at White Springs.
Anyway, where were we? Leo wanted Freddy to scout for possible startup locations. While scouting knew the burning town of Welch, he found a potential spot. When greatness called to him in the distance, an aspiring cleric was building a shrine. The anger was reignited with the smolders of the ash heap. Stephen was raised by cultists following a cryptid deity. He was also a fan of Molly's pre-war work. He had heard the calling of Freddy's sanctuary as well. The Mothman, where's Well?